Hey everybody, it's Connor. Welcome back. And today I want to talk about three tactics that I see everyone who uses ChatGPT well using these tactics. And these tactics should start to feel intuitive. So it's not a big thing you have to write down or memorize, but they are three things that when you do them well, you're going to get great outputs. So here they are in order. Number one, break down tasks. I'm going to show you how to break down tasks and also why breaking down tasks gives you the better output. That's important. Number two, they call it double shot prompting, single shot prompting, something like that. But really what it is it's just giving examples, and you want to give ChatGPT the right kinds of examples. And number three, feedback. You want to give ChatGPT feedback, but you also want to give it the right kind of feedback. And I'm going to show you what those are. So we're going to go through three demos here. And again, not something you need to write now down or write down an acronym or something like that. These should start to feel intuitive. But again, your output should really start to get a lot better when we're using these. So let's try it.
Okay, so let's do this demo. It says, read this article, which I'm going to give you in a second, summarize it, give me three insightful bullet points, then write an email to my boss telling her why we need to take generative AI seriously based on the argument in this article and create an action plan. And so the article that I'm going to use is this article here from The Economist, and I'm going to just paste this entire article, okay? So again, if you remember the prompt, read it, summarize it, give me three insightful bullet points, write an email to my boss, and then tell her why we need to take generative action and create an action plan. So that's a lot of things right in a row. So we're going to hit go. It's going to read it. Now, ChatGPT-4 is extremely powerful, right? So here's the thing. It actually is going to do this. It's going to create a summary of the article. Then it gives me three insights. Those are pretty good. I'm assuming I'm not reading them very carefully, but then it's going to go ahead and write this email to my boss. All right. I hope this finds you well. I recently came across this, insightful article from The Economist, so it's a very well written email. And then given this, I propose that we start seriously considering how we can do that. And then here it is, the action plan I asked for. So what are we learning from this? Here's the thing. When we say break something down, it's not because ChatGPT can't do it. It can't say right. It's not going to say right in the middle. Wait, what was I doing again? Hang on. Sorry, I was thinking of something else. When you add too many things into one prompt, it does one critical thing. It takes the human out of the loop. ChatGPT needs to be guided. So for example, like if we went in here and we got the summary of this, and then we realized, okay, but it didn't really capture the part of the article that I wanted. Well, it's too late. It's already given you the insights based on that part of the article that's maybe not that important. And then based on that, it's giving you the email to your boss. And then based on that, it's giving you an action output, as opposed to something like this. Hi, give me a summary of this article. And then you paste that in. And then you can see, okay, is this capturing what's important to me? Here's where you can tweak it, right? You want to tweak it before it takes you all the way out there, right? So it's like, actually, what else did it imply about the workforce in this article? So by breaking down that task, you make sure that every part of the task is solid. Because if you just give it too many tasks at once, it's not that it gets confused. You saw it can put something out. But that's almost worse because it looks like, wow, it created everything, when that's not getting the best output. Keep a human in the loop. That is the reason why we break down tasks. Not because ChatGPT necessarily gets confused, but really mostly because it keeps us in the loop and makes every part of the output better. Okay, let's move on. Okay, tactic two, we want to give examples. It's important to do this correctly. So for example, I'll just show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a transcript of a YouTube video I did a little while ago about how teachers bend reality, I called it, and in YouTube about what they can do. And we're going to do sort of like a variation of that, right? So be an 1850 journalist and write an exciting YouTube script about a new tech that has just emerged, and write it in this style. So what I did was I went to YouTube and I downloaded the transcript of what I had done for that video. So, and it's going to take the form and the tone of that, right? So always have a writing sample at the ready. And we are going to do this. So I'm going to just, I've already cut and pasted it onto my clipboard. So this is the This is the transcript, as you can see from that short video I did, how teachers bend reality with ChatGPT. Hey, everybody, it's Connor. Welcome back, etc. Okay, so you see what I was asking. Write it in this style. So let's see what it gives me here. The age of instantaneous communication, the telegraph revolution. Hello and welcome, you inquisitive minds. I'm Jacob, your faithful scribe, here to unravel the... So it's pretty cool. Like, telegraphy, in case you aren't aware, is the means of sending messages. Right? So what it's doing is it's taking the format and the content of this thing and really using it as a format. Again, without this, it will be all over the place. So always keep a writing sample of what you do at the ready. You can keep it in Word, you can keep it in notes or something like that. That's number two. Okay, tactic number three. We're going to pick up right where we left off. Tactic number three is give feedback. So I'm going to show you what I mean by this. Let's say that we're 1850 and the only technology we've brought back with us is YouTube, which feels like a gigantic, colossal waste considering, I don't know, penicillin or something like that. But anyway, here we are. So let's say, thanks, this is great. Remember, this is the YouTube script it just came up with. Can you come up with a title for this YouTube that will make it go viral, right? So like, let's see what it comes up with here. Okay, so don't give me one. I really like to have five. Please give me five. Okay. Okay. Journey back in time. Ring, ring. It's 1850. Call an AI takes us on a time traveling. Okay, so this is all good, right? But here's the critical thing. Don't just take this and like pick one. This is when you iterate. This is when you give it feedback. So let's see. Like, okay, so 1850 calls in 2023. This is like a little bit lame. Number four, dial back to number five. See, number two, I really like. So number two is great. I love the opening, but I really love the end part of number one, right? So you're giving it like pretty specific feedback. So let's see what it likes to do here. So now it's going to give us a combination. Ring, ring, it's 1850 calling. AI takes us on a mind-blowing. Anyway, it doesn't matter what the output is. What really matters is that you want to just keep giving feedback, keep iterating, and make sure that it understands.
Sooner or later, this is going to become very intuitive, but you have to practice. These are the tactics that I see people using who are absolutely outstanding at it. I want you to try it too. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to this channel and like it if it was useful, and I'll see you next time.